Good morning, students. So in the previous class, we have discussed about the factors affecting the resistance of a conductor. And I had given a question, name the factors which affect the resistance. So how many factors are there? Four factors are there which affect the resistance of a conductor. And these four factors are, the first one is nature of the material of the conductor. The second one is the length of the wire. The third is cross-sectional area, and the fourth one is the temperature of the conductor. Okay, now we'll discuss one by one with an activity. See here on page number 205, activity 12.2, which shows that different materials, different will be the resistance of a conductor. First, I'll read this activity, then I'll explain it. Take a nichrome wire, a torch bulb, a 10 watt bulb, an emitter, a plug key and some connecting wires. Set up the circuit connecting four dry cells, each of 1.5 volt in series, with an emitter leaving a gap of XY in the circuit as shown in figure 12.4. Okay, so first you have to make a circuit in which there are four cells connected in series. Each cell is of 1.5 volt. Okay, so when they are connected in series, the source voltage increases, that is 1.5 into 4, that is 6 volts. Okay, now this is connected to a key or a switch. Okay, and is connected to an ammeter. Ammeter is a device which measures the electric current in a circuit. Okay, then a gap is kept XY. Okay, now in this gap, different material wires will be connected. Okay, different material wires will be connected. And the emitter reading will be noted down. Okay, different material wires will be connected and the emitter reading will be noted down. The emitter reading is less, it means the current is less, that is more is the resistance. So different wires will be connected. And we'll find that the emitter reading will be different. Emitter reading is different means different will be the resistances of this materials of the conductor. Okay, so here now let's read it. Complete the circuit by connecting the nichrome wire in the gap XY. So first, which wire is connected? A nichrome wire is connected in the gap XY. Okay, and note down the emitter reading. Plug the key and note down the emitter reading. Take out the key from the plug. Always take out the key from the plug after measuring the current through the circuit. So first, a nichrome wire is connected. Okay, and the emitter reading is noted down. Now replace the, now take out the nichrome wire. Replace the nichrome wire with the torch bulb in the circuit and find out the current through it by measuring the reading of the emitter. Now the torch bulb is connected. The filament of that torch bulb will have different, it is made up of different material, so it will have different resistance. So then the torch bulb is connected. Now repeat the above step with a 10 watt bulb in the gap XY. Okay, then a 10 watt bulb is connected. Are the emitter readings differ for different components in the gap XY? What do the above observations indicate? You may repeat this activity by keeping any material component in the gap. Observe the emitter reading in each case and analyze the observations. Okay, so first a nichrome wire is connected in the gap XY. Note down the emitter reading. Then a 10 volt bulb is connected. Again note down the emitter reading. Then a torch bulb is connected. Again note down the emitter reading. Okay, and you may connect different material wires. And every time you will see that the emitter reading differs. The emitter reading is different. Okay, that is the current is different. And we know that I is equal to V upon R. The voltage source is the same. So, current is inversely proportional to resistance as here. The voltage source is the same. So, the current is inversely proportional to the resistance. So it means the resistances are different. So what conclusion can be drawn from here? Different materials will have different resistances. Okay, different materials, different will be the value of resistance. So the first factor on which it depends is the nature of the material. Different material wires, different will be the resistance. Okay, first we have taken a nichrome bulb, then a thin wall bulb, then a torch bulb. Every time the emitter reading is different, what does it indicate? Emitter reading different is the resistance is different. More is the current in the emitter, less will be the resistance and vice versa. Okay, less is the current in the circuit, it means more is the resistance. So different materials, different resistances. Okay, so what is the first factor on which the resistance depends? It depends upon the nature of the material. You use different material bars in the gap XY. Every time you will see that the emitter reading is different, it means the resistance is different. Okay, so this is the first factor. In this activity, we observe that the current is different for different components. Why do they differ? Certain components offer an easy path for the flow of electric current, while the others resist it. Okay, some are allowing the current to flow through it easily. That is, the emitter reading will be more. So some materials are allowing the current to flow through them easily, whereas some other materials, they are offering some resistance, appreciable resistance, so that the emitter reading is less. We know that motion of the electrons in an electric circuit constitutes an electric current. The electrons, however, are not completely free to move within a conductor. They are restrained by the attraction of the atoms among which they move. Thus, the motion of the electrons through a conductor is retarded by its resistance. Okay, we know that. We say that the current can easily flow. It means the electrons are flowing in the opposite direction of the conventional direction of current. So, whenever we say that the current electrons are flowing, it means these electrons are moving easily. Okay, now these electrons, it is made up of atoms, as we know that, the conductor, there are so many atoms surrounding it. So, these atoms are resisting to flow this electrons. They are opposing the electrons to flow. So, that is why the resistance comes into play and the emitter reading reduces. Okay, so some materials, they easily allow the electrons to flow through it, okay, or easily allow the electric current to flow through it, so they have low resistance, whereas some materials, they resist the current to flow through it, that is, they have a higher resistance. Okay, now here it is given, a component of a given size that offers a low resistance is called as a good conductor, whereas a conductor having some appreciable resistance, we call it as a resistor. Okay, and a component of identical size that offers a higher resistance is called as a poor conductor. And an insulator of the same size, even higher resistance, we call it as, it is an insulator. Okay, so first we call this, whatever wire we are connecting over here, we call it as a resistor. So, resistor means it is a conductor having some resistance. Okay, any conductor which is having some resistance, every conductor has some resistance. Every conductor opposes the current to flow through it or opposes the flow of electrons. Every conductor opposes. Okay, but some oppose more, some oppose less. Okay, so any conductor which is having some resistance, we call it as a resistor. So, resistor means the nichrome wire which we have connected first, that is a resistor. Or when we connect a torch bulb, the filament of the torch bulb, that is a resistor. A 10 volt bulb is connected, the filament of the 10 volt bulb is a resistor. So any conductor which is having a resistor, which is having a resistance, we call it as a resistor. Okay, now some conductors easily allow the current to flow through it. Okay, that is, they offer very low resistance. Such conductors are called as the good conductors of electricity. They are called as the good conductors of electricity, that is, their resistance is very, very low. Whereas a conductor, okay, of the same size, identical, but it is offering high resistance, such a conductor we call it as a poor conductor. Now, any material identical, but it is offering very, very high resistance, that is, it is not at all allowing the current to flow through it. Such materials we call it as insulators. Okay, so good conductors means which offer low resistance. Poor conductors means which offer high resistance. Insulators means the materials which are offering very, very high resistance, which are not at all allowing the current to flow through them. They are called as the insulators. And resistor means any conductor which is having some appreciable resistance, that we call it as the resistor. Okay, based on it, you will write the next question. Write down, give an activity to show that resistance of a wire, to show that the resistance of a wire depends upon nature of the material. Depends upon nature of the material of that conductor. Okay, so the first activity, to show that the resistance depends upon the nature of the material. Okay, with this diagram you will explain it. Okay, as explained here, you will explain it in the same manner. This is the activity, draw the diagram, circuit diagram. Okay, then write the next question, what are resistors? Any conductor having appreciable resistance. So what is the answer? Any conductor having some resistance is called as a resistor. Okay, then write the next question. What are good conductors, poor conductors and insulators? Okay, then the next question is, write down the next question. Show that the resistance depends upon the length of a conductor. Okay, by an activity. Okay, so the activity 12.3. Complete an electric circuit consisting of a cell, an ammeter, a nichrome wire of length L, say mark 1, and a plug key as shown in figure 12.5. Now plug the key, note down the current in the ammeter, replace the nichrome wire by another nichrome wire of the same thickness, but twice the length, that is 2L marked as 2. Now note down the ammeter reading. Okay, this much. These 4 points, they are representing for the length. So what you have to do, the circuit diagram is the same. The gap also is the same. The same circuit has to be made. Okay, so again we take 4 cells, each of voltage 1.5 volt connected in series. So the total voltage source is 6 volts. Again there is a gap xy, we connect a key and an ammeter. Now in the gap xy, first connect a nichrome wire. Okay, let us name it as 1. And its length is L. So we connect a nichrome wire. Nichrome is an alloy made up of some elements like nickel, chromium, iron, etc. Okay, so we connect a nichrome wire, it's an alloy, in the gap XY whose length is L. Capital L is the length. And note down the emitter reading. Okay, we note down the emitter reading. Now, take out this wire and connect another wire of the same thickness, same material. That is, this wire 2 is also made up of nichrome and the thickness of the wire is the same. But the length is doubled. Now the length is how much? 2L. Now remove this L length wire, L length nichrome wire, and connect this wire, the another wire 2, whose length is 2L. Okay, but it is made up of the same material, that is nichrome only, and also the same thickness. Again, note down the emitter reading. First wire connecting this wire. First wire, note down the emitter reading. Remove this wire first and connect the wire to. Again, note down the emitter reading. What you will find when you connect the second wire. Okay, suppose first you have connected the first wire of length A and you get the current to be I. When you connect the second wire whose length is double the length of the first one, then you see that the current will be half of the previous current. Now the current will be I by 2. The voltage source is the same. I is equal to V upon R. Voltage source is the same. It means what has changed? The resistance has changed. That is why the current has changed, and that is why the emitter is showing different readings. Okay, for once, first you connect this L length wire and you get the current, get it to be I. Then you connect the other wire whose length is 2L, then you get the current I by 2. So, what conclusion can you draw? We have said current is inversely proportional to the resistance. It means in which case the resistance is more? In the second case, the resistance is more, that is why the current is reduced. So it means the resistance for the second wire is more than the first. How much it is more? It is double the resistance. The resistance is double than the first case. So what conclusion can you draw? That the resistance is depending upon the length. More the length, more is the resistance. That is why the current is reduced. So resistance is directly proportional to the length of the wire. So what conclusion can you draw from this activity? That the resistance is directly proportional to the length of the wire. Okay, so once again I repeat. First you connect a nichrome wire of length L. Note down the emitter reading, let it is equal to I. Now connect, remove this wire 1 and connect another wire 2 which is also made up of nichrome and of the same thickness. Okay, but its length is 2L. Now this time you see that the current is half. Current becomes I by 2. Current becomes I by 2, it means, sorry, this current is inversely proportional. Okay, the current becomes I by 2. What does it mean? That is the resistance increases. Okay, when you double the length, the current is half, it means the resistance is double. So, what conclusion do we draw? Resistance is directly proportional to the length of the wire. So, the second factor on which the resistance depends is the length of the wire. More the length, more is the resistance, and how it is depending? Directly proportional to the length. Okay? Current reduces, it means the resistance is more. So, here the current reduces in the second case, it means the resistance is more. Current is half, it means the resistance is double. So we can say that the resistance is directly proportional to the length of the wire. So this is the second factor, and by this activity you can explain that the resistance is directly proportional to the length. Okay. Then the next factor is cross-sectional area, area of cross-section. Okay. How it depends upon the area of cross section in the same activity it is given. Okay, the fourth or the fifth point. Okay, instead of taking a nichrome wire, no, not this one. Now replace the wire by a thicker nichrome wire of the same length L, mark 3, thicker as a larger cross sectional area. Again, note down the current reading through the circuit. Okay, now what has to be done? First you connect this wire only, marked as 1, which is made up of nichrome, has some particular thickness and its length is L. Okay, now this is for cross-sectional area. Now what you have to do? You have to take another wire, same length, made up of nichrome only, same length, but double the thickness than the first one. Let this wire is marked as 3. 2 we have taken as 2L. Okay, so let us make this wire as 3. Okay, so first you have to connect wire 1, which is made up of nichrome, having a length L. Note down the emitter reading, let the emitter reading is I. Okay, then we have to connect, remove this wire, and connect another wire which is also made up of nichrome. The material is the same, made up of nichrome only. Okay, the length is also the same, L only, but it has double the thickness than the first one. So its thickness is double, that is the cross-sectional area is double than the first one. Okay, what do you mean by cross-sectional area? If you see the wire, these ends, they are circular. This area, this circular area, we call it as the cross-sectional area or area of cross-section. So this cross-sectional area is double than the first one. The third wire is having the double the cross-sectional area than the first one. Okay, again note down the emitter reading. This time you will see that if by connecting the first wire the current reading is I, now by connecting the third wire you will see that the current is double the first one. Now the current is 2I. Again we see that the voltage source is same, so the current is inversely proportional to the resistance. Okay, now the current is doubled, it means the resistance is half. So more thicker the wire, that is double the thickness of the wire, the resistance is half. So it means how is the resistance depending upon the cross-sectional area? Resistance is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. Thicker the wire, double the thickness, double the area of cross-section, what happens? The resistance is half. So that is why the current is double. Okay, so the activity is first connect the wire marked 1 made up of nichrome and of length L, okay, of a particular thickness. And note down the emitter reading, length is equal to I. Now connect another wire which is marked 3. Same length, same material, but cross-sectional area is double than the first one. Now connect the wire 3. Okay, this time you will see that the current is doubled. Current is doubled, it means as the current is inversely proportional to the resistance, it means the resistance is half. So what can you conclude? The resistance is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. More the cross-sectional area, the resistance is less. Okay, so that is why the current is more. Like here in this case, double the cross-sectional area, resistance is half, so the current is double. Okay, so resistance is the third factor is cross-sectional area, and how is the resistance depending upon the cross-sectional area? It is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. Okay, so this is the third activity. So you can write the question. Give an activity to show that resistance depends upon the cross-sectional area of the wire. Resistance depends upon the cross-sectional area of the wire. Okay, so this is the third factor with the third activity you will explain. Okay, so you have to show how the resistance depends upon the cross-sectional area. So what conclusion you draw? Resistance is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. Cross-sectional area means thickness, you can say. More thicker the wire, less will be the resistance. Okay, then the next one is nature of material. Okay, here earlier also activity 12.2 was given. Now one more thing here it is given. Notice the difference. Instead of taking a nichrome wire, connect a copper wire marked 4 in the circuit. Let the wire be of the same length, same cross-sectional area as the first. Note down the value of the current. Does the current depend upon the length? Does the current depend upon the cross-sectional area? So here you see that the current depends upon, or the resistance depends upon the length. The resistance also depends upon the cross-sectional area, and also it depends upon the nature of the conductor. Okay, so for nature of the material, this activity can also be given. Okay, first you connect a nichrome wire of length L, particular cross-sectional area, particular thickness. Now take another wire, let us mark it as 4. Okay, let us take another wire 4, which is made up of copper. Okay, same length, L length only, and same thickness. This is nichrome wire, particular length, particular cross sectional area. This is copper wire, same length, same cross sectional area. Not the material is different. First connect this wire, note down the emitter reading, then connect the cold wire and copper wire and note down the reading. You will see that the emitter reading is different. So it means it is also depending upon the nature of the material of the conductor. So this activity may also be given for the nature of the material. So we connect first the nichrome wire, note down the emitter reading. Then connect the copper wire, which is having the same length and same cross sectional area as the nichrome, as the one. Connect this wire and again note down the emitter reading. You will see that the emitter reading is different. Okay, the case in which the emitter reading is less, it means that wire is having more resistance. So by this activity, you can also show that the resistance is depending upon the nature of the material of the conductor. Okay, so it is observed that the emitter reading decreases to 1/2 when the length of the wire is doubled. Already explained. The emitter reading is increased when a thicker wire of the same material, same length is used. A change in the emitter reading is observed when a different material of same length, same cross sectional area is used. Okay, like first we use the nichrome wire, then we use the copper wire. On applying Ohm's law, we observe that the resistance of the conductor depends upon the length, on its cross sectional area, and on the nature of the material. Okay, also it is depending upon the temperature. And how is it depending upon the temperature? More the temperature of the conductor or more the temperature of the wire, more will be its resistance, not directly proportional. Okay, but it will increase. So more the temperature of the wire, more will be its resistance. Okay, this we are discussing about the conductor. Okay, so if the temperature is constant, okay, if the temperature generally at room temperature we are doing, so the temperature is constant. When the temperature is constant, okay, unless you are heating the wire, then the temperature increases. Okay, if the temperature is constant, then it is depending only on three factors. Which three factors? Length, cross sectional area, and the nature of the material. Okay, so if the temperature is constant, then it is depending only on three factors. If the temperature is changing, then it is also depending upon the temperature. And how is it depending upon the temperature? More the temperature of the conductor, more will be its resistance. Okay, so these are the four factors. Okay, then we have to discuss resistivity of a wire. Okay, so let's continue. Write the next question, then I'll explain. Define resistivity or specific resistance of a wire. Define resistivity, which is also called as specific resistance. Specific resistance of a wire. Define resistivity or specific resistance. Okay, just now we have seen that the resistance depends upon four factors, but if the temperature is constant, it is depending upon length, cross-sectional area, and the nature of the material. Now, if the wire is also the same, if the wire, suppose you have taken a copper wire, so the material of the wire is same. If the material of the wire is same, then the resistance is only depending upon two factors. What are those two factors? It is directly proportional to the length, and it is inversely proportional to the cross-sectional area. What is constant here? Temperature is constant. And let the nature of the material is also the same. That is same conductor, same wire, same material. Okay, if the temperature is constant and the nature of the material is same, then the resistance is depending upon length and cross-sectional area. And also depending upon length, directly inversely. Combining these two, what do we get? R is proportional to L upon A. Combining these two, what do we get? R is proportional to L upon A. And whenever we remove the proportionality sign and equate it, a constant of proportionality comes. Here the constant of proportionality is represented by the Greek symbol, which is called as rho. It is called as in Greek, it is called as rho. So this symbol is called as rho in Greek. And here this rho represents the resistivity or the specific resistance. So equating it, the constant of proportionality is rho. So R is equal to rho L upon A, where this rho is called as the resistivity or the specific resistance of the conductor. So what is this rho called? Rho is in Greek, like we have alpha, beta, gamma, all these are the Greek symbols. Theta, that is also the Greek symbol. So all these are the Greek symbols. I mean Greek symbol, like alpha. What is the symbol? This is the symbol. This symbol we call it as alpha in Greek. So this symbol in Greek, it is called as rho. And what is rho representing here? Rho is representing the resistivity or the specific resistance. So R is equal to rho L upon A, where this rho is called as the specific resistance or resistivity. Okay, so you will write down as such. Okay, if the temperature is constant and for a given wire, resistance is directly proportional to length, inversely proportional to cross sectional area, combining, you get this equating, that is remove the proportionality sign and equate it, positive of proportionality is rho. So this rho is called as the resistivity or specific resistance. Okay, so from here, rho is equal to R into A upon N. Rho is equal to R into A upon N. Now what is this rho representing? If the materials are different, rho will be different. Okay, we'll come to it later on. First let's define it. If the length is unit meter, that is 1 meter, cross-sectional area is 1 meter square, then rho is equal to R. So, if length is equal to 1 meter and let that wire is having a cross-sectional area of 1 meter square, then you get from this formula, substitute A is equal to 1, L is equal to 1, you will get rho is equal to R. Now let us define it. The specific resistance is the resistance of a wire whose length is 1 meter and cross-sectional area is 1 meter square. So what is specific resistance? It is the resistance of the wire only whose length is 1 meter and the cross-sectional area is 1 meter square. So this way the resistivity can be defined. Then you will define the resistivity. After writing all this, you will define resistivity. Resistivity is defined as the resistance of a conductor whose length is 1 meter and cross-sectional area is 1 meter square. Now let's come to the unit of resistivity. Unit of resistivity, let's write the units of all these physical quantities. R is having a unit, ohm. Area is having a unit, meter square. Length is having a unit, meter. So what is the unit of resistivity? The SI unit of resistivity is ohm into meter. Okay, so what is the SI unit of resistivity? Ohm into meter. So write the question, write the next question. So you have written this question, define resistivity or specific resistance. Okay, define it. First write down this mathematically and then you will define it. After writing this formula, you will define resistivity is the resistance of a conductor whose length is 1 meter and cross-sectional area is 1 meter square. Okay, then write the next question. What is the SI unit of specific resistance? Write the SI unit of specific resistance. Okay, so tomorrow we'll discuss few more things about resistivity. Okay, which materials are having more resistivity, alloys are having more, or its constituent metals are having more resistivity, we'll be discussing tomorrow. Okay, so for today, revise and complete the questions, complete the answers, that is the writing work in your copy.